Hello everyone, I'm Smart Vision. Today, we're going to test an incredibly powerful AI image editing tool. Qwen Image Edit 2509. This time, we're going head-to-head with Google's Nano Banana, which is Gemini Flash Image, to see who the real editing champion is. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to my channel and Patreon. You can get all the resources from my Patreon. I will focus on Qwen's two killer features. The first killer feature. Simultaneous multi-image editing. Qwen supports editing up to three images at once, handling complex compositions like person plus person, person plus product, or person plus scene in a single go, which greatly streamlines the workflow. The second killer feature. Ultra-high consistency. Qwen achieves high coherence in maintaining character identity, product details, and even text within the image, significantly reducing the common AI hallucination problem, making the results more realistic and trustworthy. Where can you try it? Qwen Chat's official website offers a free trial. You can try it on Hugging Face Spaces, or run it locally via ComfyUI. Nano Banana is Google's image solution. Its strengths lie in its multi-modem capabilities and fast response, excelling at prompt-based local refinement and multi-image merging, making it highly versatile. The first scenario is multi-image composition. The goal is to merge people and products from two to three different photos into a single image or commercial poster. We input the same prompt and images for execution. I used one to two character images and one scene image as input. For Qwen, I can only show screenshots and the final results. Please bear with me as my PC only has 32 gigabytes of RAM and 16 gigabytes of VRAM. And starting screen recording easily triggers an OM error. With Qwen, we can see that the lighting, perspective, and detail retention for the person and the scene are excellent. The person and product merge naturally, and the edge processing is delicate. On the other hand, Nano Banana attempts the merge, but sometimes the person's proportions or the merging artifacts are more noticeable. So, for complex compositions, merging multiple different images into one, Qwen generally has an advantage in naturalness and detail retention. Sometimes when using Nano Banana, even though the images were self-generated, it mistakenly identifies them as real people, leading to task failure. In this case, using Qwen's local running version is more advantageous because it has no such restrictions. The second scenario is character pose control and identity retention. Simply put, it's making the same person strike a complex pose while preserving their facial features and clothing details. Using the same image and prompt, we can see that both Qwen and Nano Banana have their strengths. Qwen requires a pose stick figure as input to control the character's pose, whereas Nano Banana can make person A perform the action of person B. Looking at the results, Qwen's pose transformation is natural, and facial identity retention is stable. Nano Banana seems to struggle more with fine pose control and identity preservation. Details sometimes get lost, and it occasionally makes mistakes, though it's possible I haven't experimented enough. So Qwen performs more stably in maintaining identity consistency and precise pose control, but you must first extract the pose stick figure. To learn how to extract this stick figure, you can check out my Patreon for the corresponding workflow. The third scenario is text editing and typesetting. The task is to modify the text on a billboard within an image. I used a complex, self-generated street scene with many billboards. I instructed them to change the text on the leftmost yellow billboard to Smart Vision and Hello, respectively. Looking at the results, both Qwen and Nano Banana had mediocre performance, with missing characters or failing to edit at all. This might be due to not understanding which billboard was the leftmost yellow one, or perhaps too many characters to fit on the sign. However, Nano Banana's result was slightly more accurate. The conclusion is that if your work heavily relies on text editing, you can choose either model. The fourth scenario is object removal and background replacement. Here I use Qwen and Nano Banana to remove people and rain streaks from complex images respectively. I tested with one complex street scene and one street scene after the rain. In terms of results, Qwen's local running version was not as good as Nano Banana at removing people from the image. The person was not cleanly removed, and neither model performed well on the task of removing rain streaks. The fifth scenario is style transfer, converting a photo into a Van Gogh oil painting style. I used a fictional AI-generated image for this test. The results show that both models perform comparably well. The sixth scenario is image restoration and colorization. Repairing old photos, adding color, and enhancing details in blurry photos. I input an old photo of Japan from the early 20th century with the prompt to restore the image and enhance details. Let's look directly at the results. Qwen was excellent in detail recovery and color naturalness, showing a significant improvement. Nano Banana was also decent in some restoration asks, but the overall feeling was slightly inferior. The seventh scenario is a practical test of advertising on poster design. The task is to integrate multi-image composition, text editing, and product presentation to create a professional advertising poster. I used an AI-generated image of glasses and asked it to design a poster and include my specified prompt text. Looking directly at the results, Qwen simply wrote the text onto the image, with almost no modification to the picture itself. Nano Banana, however, adjusted the angle of the glasses, making it look more like a poster, and the text it generated seemed more professional. Therefore, I think Nano Banana performed better here. The eighth scenario is clothing replacement. I used an AI-generated image of a woman wearing a blue dress and a synthetic image of a skirt. Looking at the results, Qwen successfully replaced the skirt onto the woman. The result was decent, though sometimes traces of the original long dress remain. Nano Banana failed this task, unable to put the skirt on even after multiple attempts. Of course, in simpler scenes, trying on clothes would succeed, but here I wanted to showcase their limitations. The ninth scenario is perspective replacement. I used an image of a car to change the perspective, specifically viewing the car from the front and viewing the outside from inside the car. Looking directly at the results, Qwen's front view image was better than Nano Banana's, although some traces were not completely cleaned up. Nano Banana failed this task, making no modification to the image. For the perspective of looking outside from inside the car, although both models produced seemingly good images, they were actually both incorrect. The car's front should be facing the opposite direction. They needed to generate a fictional foreground, but instead they both treated the background as the foreground. So overall, Qwen and Nano Banana are about equal. If we were to score them using a table, Qwen and Nano Banana each excel in different scenarios. Qwen scores higher in multi-image composition, character consistency, and text processing, specializing in merging different images into a highly consistent final product in detail restoration and identity preservation. Nano Banana performs well in quick drafts, certain automatic poster optimizations, and specific removal tasks. In practice, I suggest integrating both into your work. Use Nano Banana for prototyping and Qwen for fine-minus tuning, achieving the optimal balance of efficiency and quality. Now that the comparison is complete, I want to share some workflows to boost your efficiency. These workflows are mainly for the convenient batch production of character scenes. I hope you'll like, share, and subscribe to my channel. First, we install ComfyUI. After installation, when you open it, you can click this location to see many templates. Here, we search for Qwen and can find the Qwen Image Edit 2509 template. Clicking it allows for simple usage. The original workflow uses a full precision model, which is quite large and difficult for a typical home computer to run. Therefore, we can use GGUI. My computer has 16 gigabytes of VRAM, so I use the Q3 model. Why not use Q4? Because Q4 almost completely fills the VRAM, making it very prone to OOM errors during the final VIE decoding step, so I didn't use it. If you have 8 gigabytes of VRAM, you can use the Q2 model, but your system or IAM must be greater than 32 gigabytes, otherwise, the system is likely to crash. I reached this conclusion because one of my computers with only 8 gigabytes of VRAM and 32 gigabytes of system or AM has crashed many times. After each generation, I recommend clicking the free model button to release memory and avoid OOM errors. I found that when used continuously, ComfyUI doesn't release memory, which can quickly lead to a memory overflow and system crash. and it's best if the sizes of the images are the same. Otherwise, ComfyUI is prone to crashing. That's why I added a resize image node here. If you want to generate an image with a specific pose, you need to extract the stick figure, and you can use this workflow. Here, we need to add these nodes, which can extract the stick figure of the person in the image, and then connect the stick figure here. That's all there is to it. Additionally, I have prepared a workflow that can generate multiple prompt images at once. For instance, these workflows can generate images for single or multiple character scenes based on a single setup. This workflow is responsible for batch generating scenes for a single character. You set the image for the first character here. Here, you set the path to the text file containing the scene description prompts. I've also provided a template for this text file. Just write one scene per line, it's very simple. Qwen Image Edit might not be the best at generating scenes, so we can use Flux Krea or EA instead, or generate them beforehand. You write the folder path for each scene image here. I've divided them into three groups. You can select the group you need, enable it, and disable the others. The reason for using Flux is that, in my personal opinion, it is the most stable and best performing open source solution currently available. Other parameters do not need to be adjusted. This is the workflow for generating scene images with two characters together. Usage is essentially the same as the single character workflow, except you need to set the image for character to here. The workflow for generating scene images with three characters together is as follows. I'll briefly explain the principle so you can freely create multi-character workflows according to your own needs later. To add a character, we can copy the node here and specify the image for that character. At the same time, we need to add another node here to connect this character's node to it, and so on. That's it. Furthermore, we can control the style of the generated images using LoRA. We can download these LoRAs from this website. When downloading, we must be careful to choose the LoRA that corresponds to the base model, otherwise, issues will arise. After downloading, place the LoRA file into the LoRA folder. Then we add a load LoRA node here and select the downloaded LoRA model. If you can't find it, you can right-click to reload the node or restart ComfyUI. Alright, that concludes this episode. I hope you like, share, and subscribe to my channel on Patreon. Your support is the biggest motivation for my creation.